Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are happy and healthy. In today's math session, we will discuss about percentage. Percentage means we have now reached to lesson 6 of our maths book. The lesson is percentage. Let's begin the session. Percentage. Percent or per cent means 1/100. Therefore, 1% means 1/100 or 1/100th, and 3% means 3/100 or 3/100ths. Since percentages are just 100th parts, which means they are fractions, we can very easily write them as fractions and as decimals. Children, look at the left hand side figure or image. This is the image of percentage. We denote percentage through this symbol, one slash, and both side of the slash we are having two small zeros. So this is the symbol of percentage. Children, come to the right side grid. At the bottom most grid, you have got 10x10 grid, and where 3 squares are selected. That means the selected portion is 3 out of 100. So I can write them in a fraction like 3/100. And this 3/100, if we want to convert it in the decimal, so we can write this as 0.03. And similarly, children, when we are writing 3/100 or 3/100, that means it is 3%, 3 portion out of 100. So we can say it is 3%, or we can say 3/100. Okay, so percent can be explained this way. 3/100 means it is 3%, and percent means 1% means per cent, means a portion of 1/100th. Percent or percent means 1/100th. The symbol for percent is like this, one slash, and both sides of slash is having small zero. This is the symbol of percent. Therefore, 1% means 1/100 or 1/100th. And 7% means 7/100 or 7/100ths. The words percent actually means per hundred in the language of Latin. So originally percent word is coming from Latin. Since percentages are just 100th parts, we can very easily write them as fractions and as decimals. Yes, how we will write down percentage in the form of fraction and in the form of decimal? Now I will discuss with you. Suppose I am having 63%. Then if I want to express this 63% in fraction, that means 63/100. And when I am denoting 63/100, that means in decimal it is 0.63. Similarly, I am having another number that is of 9%. So if I want to express this 9% in fraction, then I will write 9/100. And when I am writing 9/100, that term can be expressed in the form of decimal as 0.09 in decimal. Isn't it, children? I hope and I think the conception regarding percentage is clear to you. Now we will move forward towards the greater details about percentage. My next topic is conversion of fractions into percent. So how do we convert a fraction into percent? Let's learn. I have already told you percent means per hundred. So try to change the fraction to the number divide 100 form. Yes, when we are converting a fraction into percent, try to change the fraction into in the form of number divide 100 form. When we will convert a fraction into percent, that time we have to follow these steps. Step number one, find a number. You can multiply the bottom of the fraction by to get 100. That means we have to settle down. We have to find out a number. Through that number, if we multiply the bottom of the fraction, so that we can get the denominator as 100. Yes. Step two. Now, what to do? Multiply both top and bottom of the fraction by that number. Yes. So, first of all, we have to find out a number. The number, if we multiply the number with the denominator of the fraction so that we can receive 100. So find out, first of all, we have to find out such number. Then second step, we have to multiply that number with the numerator and the denominator of the fraction. Step three, then write down just the top number with the percentage sign. Now children, come to an example for better explanation. Suppose I am having a number 4/5. That means 4 out of 5. And we have to change it into percentage. What we will do? We have to find out a number so that if we multiply that number with 5, we can get total 100. So what is that number? Children, I am saying that number is 20. Check, if I multiply 5 with 20, I will get the denominator as 100, isn't it? So clearly the first part is that I have to find out one number. If I multiply that number with the denominator, I must get the denominator as 100. Here 4/5 is the number. If I multiply 20 with 5, then I will get 100 as denominator. And children, directly I cannot multiply a number with the denominator only. So I have to multiply that number with the numerator as well as the denominator. So 4 by 5 equal to 4 into 20 as well as 5 into 20. So I'm getting the number 80 by 100. That means my answer is 80%. Children, second example, convert 1 by 4 into percent. Same way, children, denominator is 4 and now I have to find out one number. With that number, if we multiply 4, I must get 100. So what is the number? The number is 25. If I multiply 4 with 25, then I will get 100. So 1 by 4 equal to 1 into 25, 4 into 25. So answer is 25 by 100. And I can say 25 by 100 means 25%. Another example. Children, convert 3 by 16 to a percent. How we will do it? Beta, if we multiply 16 with 6.25, then we will get as a denominator 100. So we cannot do like this directly. We have to multiply 3 with 6.5 as well as 16 with 6.25. Sorry children, I have pronounced a bit wrong. I have to multiply 3 with 6.25 as well as 16 with 6.25. Yes. So what is my question? I have to convert 3 by 16 into percent. What to do? I have to find a number. If I multiply that number with 16, I must get the result whole 100. So here, what is the number? 6.25. So I am multiplying 3 with 6.25, 16 with 6.25. So now I am getting the answer 18.75 by 100. 18.75 by 100. So I can say the answer is 18.75%. Next, we will learn about conversion of percent into fractions. Yes, children, how we will convert a percent into fraction. For that, we have to follow certain steps. Step number one, write down the percent divide by 100 like this. Percent, the digit I am having, divide 100. If the percent is not a whole number, yes, complexity will arise. If the number is a decimal number, then what we will do? Then multiply both top and bottom by 10 for every number after the decimal point. Yes. For example, if there is one number after the decimal, then what to do? We will multiply 10 with the numerator, 10 with the denominator. Similarly, if I'm having the number which is having 2 points after decimal, then what to do? I have to multiply numerator as well as denominator with 100. And thirdly, simplify or reduce the fraction. Children, now I will discuss one example with you for the better understanding of the concept. Suppose I am having a number 5 whole number and 1 by 4 as fractional part. That means 5 and 1 4 percent. Yes, the number is 5 and 1 4 percent. Now this is a mixed fraction percentage. So change it to improper fraction percent. 5 and 1 4 percent is converted into 21 by 4 percent. Now it is not a decimal point, so what to do? Just directly divide 100 with that number. So I will write 21 by 4 divide 100. So what I will get after simplification, I will get 21 by 4 into 100. So answer is 21 by 400. Another example, suppose I have to convert 11% into fraction. There is no decimal point in this question, so there is no hazard at all. Just I will write 11 divide 100 and I will reach to the answer. There is no decimal point, that's why I don't need to go for the second step. Directly I will reach to the third step, and that is answer is 11 by 100. Next, we will come to know about percent of a number. How do we find out percent of a number? Example, convert 75% to a fraction. Write down 75 by 100. Yes, all you know, 75% means 75 by 100. The percent is a whole number, so straightly go to step 3. Simplify the fraction. Yes, we have to do the simplification directly. So what we can do? Children, I can do it directly or I can do it in the step-by-step fashion. How? 75 and 100. So I can directly divide the numerator and the denominator with 25. So I can reach the answer 3 by 4, and 3 by 4 means 0.75. Another way, how do I get the decimal fraction? Suppose I am having 75 by 100. I will divide my numerator and denominator both by 5. So listen to me. First step, I am dividing my numerator and denominator by 5. Then I am reaching to the answer 15 by 20. I can reduce in more. Means I can reduce into the next step also. Again, if I divide 15 and 20 by 5, then my numerator will be 3, my denominator will be 4. Now 3 by 4. 3 is a prime number, so we cannot go for further simplification. So we can write the answer 75 by 100 is called a decimal fraction, and the answer is 3 by 4 or 0.75. Children, at the end of the session, I will discuss with you about some word problem related to percentage. Problem number one, there are 50 students in a class. If 14% are absent in a particular day, find the number of students present in the class. Yes, total number of students are 50 and among them 14% are absent. So how do I find out the solution? Number of students absent on that particular day is 14% out of 550. So how I will write? 14% means 14 divide 100 into 50. Yes, as we know, 14% means percent, that is 40 by 100 multiplied by 50. So after simplification, I am getting the result 7. So 7 students are absent on that day, particular day, and 50 minus 7 is 43. That means 43 number of students are present on that particular day. Question number 2. In a basket of apples, 12% of them are rotten and 66 are in good condition. Find the total number of apples in the basket. Yes, children, in a basket, few apples are there, among them 12% are rotten. If the good apples, number of good apples are 66, so find out how many total number of apples are there in a basket. Let the total number of apples in the basket be M. So I am denoting the total number of apples by M. And 12% of the apples are rotten and the apples are good condition is are 66. Therefore, according to the question, if that 12% is rotten, that means 88% are good condition, isn't it? 100% is the total apples. So among them, 12% is rotten, then 88% apples are in good condition. So we can write 88% of M is 66. So 88 by 100 into M equal to 66. That means the value of M equal to 66 into 100 divide 88. So after simplification, what we are getting? After simplification, we are getting M equal to 3 into 25. That means the M equal to 75. M means the total number of apples in a basket. So I can write as an answer statement is that there are 75 number of apples are there in a basket. Once again, children, I am discussing with you about the solution. Suppose I am denoting the total number of apples by M. Among them, 12% are rotten and good condition are 66. So if we eliminate 12 from the 100, then I will get 88. So I can say 88% of M equal to 66. Yes, children. So 88% means 88 by 100 into M equal to 66. After simplification, what I am getting? M equal to 66 into 100 divide 88. Again, I am going for further simplification. And I am reaching to the point M equal to 3 into 25. And 3 into 25 means 75. And what I considered at the beginning, I have considered that M equal to 75. That means the total number of apples equal to 75. Now children, it's an activity time. Let's come to the point. We will solve now one activity. Fractions, decimals and percentage. Look at the image children at the leftmost corner. First image is showing half, 1 by 2. That is fraction 1 by 2. Second image is 1 by 4 portion is 1 among 4th portion is selected. That means 1 by 4 fraction is 1 by 4. Third image, 1 among the 5th portion is selected through blue color. So I can say fraction equal to 1 by 5. And in the last image, I can say one portion is selected among the 10th portion. So the fraction I can say 1 by 10. Now, if I convert it into the base of 100, that means if I change the number where the denominator is 100, that means in the changing format, I can write the fractions 1 by 2 equal to 50 by 100. I am multiplying and dividing both the numerator and the denominator with 50. So I'm getting the number 50 by 100. In the second fraction, I'm multiplying the numerator as well as the denominator with 25. Then I'm getting the answer 25 by 100. In the third answer, I am multiplying the numerator and the denominator with 20. So what I will get? I will get the change fraction as 20 by 100. And the third answer, third fraction, if I multiply 10 with my numerator as well as my denominator, I will get my new fraction as 10 by 100. So I can say in the form of percentage, 50 by 100 means 50%. 25 by 100 means 25%. 20 by 100 means 20%. As well as 10 by 100 means 10%. So now convert this percentage into the decimal. 50% means 0.5. Similarly, 25% means 0.25 in decimal. And more similarly, 20% means 0.2 decimal. And 10% means 0.1 in decimal. If we want to arrange them in the decimal order, the answer we will get as 0.5, 0.25, 0.2 and 0.1. Thank you, children. This much is for today's session. We will meet in our next session with a new topic. Till then, goodbye, children. Stay safe and take care of yourself. Bye, children.